folks racing dcramerica.com here. Now today we've got something a little bit different, and no, it's not actually cycling, though there's a ton of bikes right there, so a little bit different than a normal thing, but instead it's a new dive watch. Now some of you may not know, I'm a bit of a scuba diver. I've dove kind of all over the world actually over the last 15, 17 years or so, and so when Garmin kind of mentioned that they were coming out with a dive watch, I figured I'd give it a shot, and there's no cooler place to do that than NEMO 33. Now what this facility is a 33 meter deep facility. So it's indoors and it goes down 33 meters, or basically 100 feet into the ground, allows you to scuba dive indoor. Given that I live in Central Europe, where it's not terribly awesome to scuba dive, this is sort of the best place to do it. Note that neither NEMO 33 or Garmin paid me for any of this. In fact, I paid all my own way. So what I want to do is walk through what's unique about this watch in particular. And what it essentially is a Fenix 5X with some extra goodness on top of it. Now, a lot of people in the past have tried to do Connect IQ apps that are diving focused with Garmin's Fenix series previously, but Garmin was always super hesitant about those because of the fact that there wasn't a depth gauge within the watch itself. With the Descent Mark II comes the depth gauge, but also some mechanical changes behind the scenes. First off, the fact that you've got a bit of a different charger than you have in the rest of the Fenix 5 series. That's the new 2017 universal charger. Here they've gone with something akin to the Fenix 3 charger, and that's because they wanted to ensure that it's fully waterproofed and dive certified. So they have certified this device up to 100 meters of diving depth. And there's a couple things they did to that. One is they followed a certain standard for diving, and two, they went ahead and also ensured that for bumping and things like that, it can also withstand those pressures as well. Now, in a lot of ways, it is a Fenix 5 unit through and through, and 5X unit in particular, so it does have things like mapping on it, GPS, all the other sports you get, running, cycling, it's a full smartwatch, it can download apps to it. But that's where you get into some of the differences between this and other Fenix 5 units. First off, you have a bunch of dive modes. Those dive modes are not on the other Fenix 5 watches. When you go into those dive modes there, you get essentially five different core areas. One is single gas, multi-gas, gauge, which basically means no gas, apnea, and apnea hunt. You also have the ability to plan a dive as well. So you can go ahead and calculate your dive table effectively on the watch itself, and then you can go diving based on which dive sport you have. Now, once you start a dive profile, this is where things get a little different from the past and other Garmin watches. Okay, so once you're ready to dive, you can go ahead and simply start like you would an activity. So you see here all the different dive profiles, single gas, multi-gas, gauge, apnea, apnea hunt. This is plan dive, so I can go into plan dive, for example, and compute my NDL, and go ahead and just simply set the oxygen percentage and then enter my depth or my time. So if I enter the depth, for example, and just go down into, let's just say 90 feet, click OK, then you can see my NDL right there, as well as the depth and the maximum dive as well. I can go into options, and I can add repeat dives and so on, essentially just creating a dive profile for the day. And if I go back here, I'm just going to keep on going back. You can see I can go down into other sports as well. So there's the map, for example. That's used just to look at where I am, my location, run, bike, and so on, all the different sports that you would normally see on a Garmin Fenix 5. But in particular, these are the ones that matter here on the Descent Mark II. So if we look at gauge, this is what I would do. I'm going to go and enter there, and then I go into it. And now it's actually going to try to find GPS. Now I'm indoors, it doesn't really find it very well, but it will find the GPS, and this is going to mark your start location. So essentially the point where you can go ahead and see that on a map later on. Of course, GPS underwater does not work. One thing that's also notable is in the back, you've got the optical heart rate sensor there. That actually will work here in the pool. So what Garmin's done is they found that the optical heart rate sensor works in a scuba diving environment a little bit better than it does in a typical swimming environment, because there's not that much movement like you have in swimming. So once that's all set, you're going to go ahead and start your dive. You can choose edit if you want to change things like your fresh water type, or sorry, your water type to fresh, salt, custom. You can go down to alerts. You can set, for example, a maximum depth alert. I can add alerts there for depth or time. If we go back here, we can set the dive delay, the backlight, heart rate. Again, there's the wrist heart rate I mentioned, or you can even use a chest strap. So for example, you are using a wet or a dry suit, or even a wetsuit, then you can go ahead and basically use a chest strap, and it'll sync the heart rate after the fact. So we'll go back here. At this point, I would simply hit start to start. Now, it won't actually start until I get into the water and go down in depth using that depth sensor there. And then once I'm in, I can simply press the button left-hand side, and I can iterate through these dive screens. These dive screens will show me my heart rate, for example, as well as the time of day, depth, temperature. And of course, as you're diving, if you hit alerts, or whether the ones that you've set, or things like ascending too fast, it'll trigger that. So for example, here you can see me going ahead and triggering the alert for the maximum dive depth I set for this dive at 62 feet. And the same happened if I ascended too fast, then you'll see that as well. Once you're done with your dive, you can go ahead and go surface, and that'll basically end the dive automatically after a minute. And then it's gonna try to re-find GPS again at that point. And then when it's finding GPS, it's found that, it's gonna mark the end location, so you have that on the map. If for some reason you can't get the end start locations, that's not a big deal. That's, you know, like you're in a cave or an indoor facility like this, then there's no biggie. And then once this is all done, you can go ahead and sync it to your mobile phone using Garmin Connect Mobile. And that in turn will show you your dive profile for the dive as well as a bunch of other stats for it. The dive history is also kept on the unit and then also then pushed to Garmin Connect Online where you can see it there as well. So you basically got kind of your dive book in essentially three different places, your phone, your watch, and online. Then one thing that's notable about this watch compared to others is that it does come with a longer strap, so it comes with an extra strap that you can use if you have to go around a dry suit or if it's just perhaps a really bulky wetsuit that is included in there, so both a short strap for day-to-day use and a long strap. Because it uses Garmin's quick fit system on there, you can go ahead and pop these bands off super, super quick. It takes just a second or two to pop them off, and then you can go and put on a new band if you want later on, whether it be a titanium bracelet, for example, or anything else. You're pretty much good to go in just a couple seconds. Now, one of the big concerns a lot of people have, and rightly so, is whether or not they trust Garmin to make a dive watch. I mean, it's obviously something, there's a safety element to it, and that's something that, you know, it's one thing if your watch crashes in the middle of a run, but it's a whole different ballgame if your watch has an issue down below the surface and you're counting on it to save your life. So a couple things to keep in mind. One is that Garmin's actually been in the, like, critical equipment realm for a while. They have a bunch of aviation products and a bunch of marine products. Both of those are well known in the respective industries as being very high quality. And so they've carried over there, they said they carried anyways, some of those ideas into the diving realm here as well. So the idea that they have some safety checks. Another thing to keep in mind is the fact that the watch does not run any third-party apps while you're diving. So as soon as you enable these dive modes, it basically goes into a lockdown configuration. In those configurations, you cannot run ConnectIQ apps, you cannot run ConnectIQ data fields, and it's basically a totally secured environment compared to the rest of the sport modes. It's a little more open and a little more free. And then also Garmin has said they've gone ahead and they've done a different kind of QA process for the dive profile, so that again, once you're in that profile, it's sort of a totally locked down piece of the watch that the rest of the watch is a bit different from. So with that, thanks for watching. Go and whack that like button down at the bottom there and hope you enjoyed something a little bit different than normal. Also check out the link at the description field for all sorts of other goodness. Have a good one.